So Chapter 6 is nearly out in 2 days now, and this is very, very exciting for many reasons. We get a new chapter, we get Winterfest, and then we also get Fortnite OG included just within 1 month, which is kind of insane. But we've just gotten a massive, massive leak here, and I found it just by scrolling through YouTube and just randomly finding the official trailer for Chapter 6. And because the trailer was leaked, I'm pretty sure they decided to release the trailer earlier. So today we'll go over all the little details that I could find, the good things and the bad things. And of course I have to beg for subscribers in the intro, as a lot of you hate my mic. Some of you hate it so much that you unsubscribed from my channel apparently, which is insane. So if you really want me to change my mic, get me to 10k subscribers before November is over, and I'll change it way sooner. And I know it's only a couple days left, but I would really, really appreciate it if we made it to that goal. And with that said, let's go to the trailer. So we have these first couple seconds of the video showing off some of the beautiful locations that will be in this map, and I just gotta say, it looks pretty damn good. Like this flower field, for example, with those flying kites or whatever, this is awesome, the lighting looks beautiful, the skybox is definitely a lot better than it was in Chapter 5, and this part with the bridge is also pretty cool. I don't think we've ever seen a bridge with that massive scale before, and I feel like I've definitely seen a bridge like that in Japan somewhere. And then we have this part here, with this massive turtle, which is said to move between the matches or just move within the match itself, which is really interesting. And he has trees on top, he looks like a funny guy, and if I were to have a guess, I would say that there is some nice loot in there, maybe a mythic weapon, maybe a boss. It's hard to say. It's gonna be really interesting to see what this massive turtle will be. And then at the top left, we have these flying cube islands, like the one from Season 6 in Chapter 1, and I'm unsure if this is related to the cube itself within the lore, or if it's just some purple flying islands, who really knows. But we haven't seen this many floating islands in the sky in the game ever. This is something completely different, and it looks really, really cool. Then we get to see some of the skins that will be part of the battle pass, and they are pretty good. We have some Cat, we have Baymax, we also have Hope back in the game, and then there's this jumping slurp bubble, like this guy, I don't know who he is, but he's jumping around. I mean, it looks kind of funny. I don't know what part he has in the lore or anything. It's kind of interesting though. And then we get to see part of the scene here where there's a city, everyone's fighting, and there's even a moving train, but this one being a sky train and not like the one we have in Chapter 5, so that's pretty damn cool in my opinion. And we also see Hope having this new shield that kind of is like the kinetic blade, I'm not entirely sure. Then we get to see this whole area here with the Japanese trees, cherry blossom trees, this little blob, and it's nice sort of dojo area, which is really sick. And there's even this sort of portal looking thing over here, and that's gonna be real interesting to see. Will it transport us to a different area, a boss area? Will it be mobility? Who really knows? And I gotta say, this entire area here is pretty cool. The colors and everything look like something that could have been in Chapter 4, which is a step in the right direction for the art style, that's for sure, as Chapter 5 was absolutely garbage in that regard. But then there's something that I really am not a fan of, when the skin shoots the gun. And yeah, is that bullet drop? Am I seeing bullet drop again? And I swear to God, Fortnite did not learn after all the backlash that we had towards the bullet drop in the game. It's probably around 70-80% of the people that do not like bullet drop, but they have it here again. And sure, it isn't the biggest deal out of all of it. If everything else in the chapter is good, I wouldn't really mind it that much, but still, it's just unnecessary. But anyway, then we see Baymax take the slurp guy out from his head, and I mean, come on, we have Baymax in the game, that's kind of awesome. I mean, canonically, he's way bigger than that, like, he's small compared to the other skins, I mean, this was out of nowhere. When's the last time anyone watched that show, you know? But I mean, hey, I'm not complaining, this is pretty sick. Then we have this other shot in this other dojo that's probably at another point of the map, and we can see that this guy has a kinetic blade, and yes, it seems like the kinetic blade will actually be returning, which I'm really a fan of. Those were pretty damn awesome back in Chapter 4, Season 2, and we already saw that we had another sword, so I'm really curious as to how those two would work together in one season. And then we have this weird creature that looks like the Cypher PK logo, and I don't know what this is. I don't know what this beast is supposed to be, if it's a boss, if it's whatever, but it seems like you attack it to get something. Maybe it protects some sort of mythic vault, or maybe he drops boss drops himself. I don't really know, but it's unlike anything we've seen. It's kind of weird, but it could be cool. Then we have this red sort of dojo area that looks even bigger than all the other ones, and I just have to say, red looks really, really good here, especially with the Unreal Engine 5 graphics. And I don't think we've really had a red biome in the game before, correct me if I'm wrong, but it does definitely look sick regardless. And we also get to see this guy wear this mask and shoot some fireballs, and that's gonna be something that will be fun to use, I'm sure. Maybe too OP, maybe not, and I'm assuming that was dropped from the previous beast that these people were attacking, I'm not sure. And then we get something really, really interesting that was not expected at all. Wall jumping, do you see this shit? He's jumping between the walls. Like, at this point we have every single mechanic to make a parkour game. Like, this is just parkour at this point. Fortnite has become a parkour simulator, and it's kind of sick. And then after that, we get to see this massive guardian or whatever, and he's just towering above everyone else, and I'm assuming he's a big boss of the game. And a lot of people will probably drop there, because I'm sure the mythics he drops will be absolutely insane. And then we have this scene where these tiny little clown-looking things are jumping around, and maybe these are the pets they were teasing with the leaks we had. I don't know, maybe we can ride them, maybe we can do something else. But they look kind of goofy. And then we have Godzilla walking around, and he's absolutely giant, like, holy shit. I thought he was a skin, but maybe not. I mean, look at this. Is this meant to be a live event? Is he just walking around like that all the time? I don't know. And yeah, looking at everything here, I'm pretty much excited for almost all of it, except a couple things, and we already mentioned Bullet Drop, but the next is that if you look at this scene here, you can tell that the rocks and the whole design of the map looks very similar to Chapter 5 and have sort of the same art style, which is a shame. And while it does definitely look better than Chapter 5, of course it does, it still isn't that cartoony stuff that we would like to see with the lighting, with the graphics and everything. And in my opinion, it just looks too dull and bland and not vibrant enough, honestly. But then you have these other parts where it looks really vibrant with the colorful trees, the grass looks very green, and the dojos in general all have great graphics in my opinion. And while we still haven't really seen that much of the map at all, I still am kinda disappointed with some of the areas that still look sorta like Chapter 5. And it seems like the mods are also gone, there's no showcase here with anything, so I think it's safe to say that mods are completely removed, which I'm absolutely fine with. And we also had the cinematic trailer drop just now, and it's kind of beautiful. Like, look at the map right here. It does look a lot like Chapter 4, and I'm really hopeful that the art style could be way better than Chapter 5. And I know it's just a cinematic, but everything here does look good. It's very well made, and we also see another creature that is not the turtle. I don't know what he does. He's pretty silly looking, but it's pretty much the same stuff as the other trailer, just rendered and animated beautifully. And we do see people going out of this portal, which could change up the way we play the game a lot. Who knows? And this whole season looks way more interesting than Chapter 5 Season 1 ever looked. We have a bunch of vibrant trees, a stronger art style, cooler bosses, cooler weapons, literally cooler everything, basically. I mean, we have a massive turtle walking around, which I'm assuming to be very similar to how Columbo was. We also have Godzilla apparently walking around too. But all I know is that I'm very, very excited with Chapter 6 Season 1, and if this season somehow becomes a massive flop, well then I would have Chapter 1 OG to play, so it wouldn't really be that big of a problem. But anyway, yeah, that's it for the video. Tell me down below in the comments what you think about this trailer, whether you're hyped or not, your concerns. And yeah, subscribe, we're trying to hit 10k before the month is over. I know that's not possible, but still do it anyway. And also use code JackBigBus when this season starts. I would really appreciate that. And yeah, see you next time.